In this video and the next two videos, I want to talk about the numerical problem of interpolation. In interpolation, you are given a set of points. So let's say x naught, y naught, x1, y1. So let's say n plus 1 points, so xn, yn. These are given, so that means they're supposed to be in exact values. So the y, say, is some underlying function of x, and you know the value of the function at these n plus 1 values of x. The problem of interpolation is that given some other value of x that is not on this list of x naught through xn, what is the value of y at that other value of x? So you're interpolating, that's what we say. There's three main types of numerical interpolation. One would be called polynomial interpolation. This is a global type of interpolation. So if there were only 2 points here, then you can draw a straight line between the 2 points and use that as your interpolating function. If there were 3 points, you can fit 3 points by a quadratic polynomial and use that as your interpolating function. Here we have n plus 1 points. You can fit n plus 1 points by a polynomial of degree n. Okay? So this is a global interpolating function because there's only one function then that goes through all the points. It's usually only used for a very few number of points. So you would use it, definitely use it for 2 points. You might use it for 3 points, but when you get much more than 3 points, 4 or 5 or a large number of points, it's usually not a very good method because the polynomials tend to have a lot of local maximum and minimum, a lot of wiggles, where you can even have wiggles between 2 consecutive points. So it's usually not used for interpolation when you have more than 3 or so points. To beat the wiggle problem, you do piecewise interpolation. The standard ones are piecewise linear interpolation. We can talk about that in this video. That's rather straightforward. Between every 2 consecutive points, you draw a straight line. So you're just drawing straight line between points. That's what the program plot does, the function plot does in MATLAB. You give it a bunch of points and it just connects them by a straight line. That's piecewise linear interpolation. A more sophisticated and smoother interpolating function uses cubic polynomials, and that goes by the name of cubic spline interpolation. So that's piecewise cubic polynomials. And we'll talk about that in the next two videos. Okay, so here then let's talk about piecewise linear interpolation. So we have some general interpolating function. I'll call that g of x. So y then equals g of x. This is what we call our interpolating function. Okay, but the interpolating function consists of piecewise linear functions. So we have g of x then is equal to some linear function, which I'll call gi of x, when x then is between the points xi and xi plus 1. Okay, so those are the piecewise linear functions. I can draw a graph, so maybe it will be easier to see. So here is our x, here is our y. Let's say we have a bunch of points then, so I can draw points. Okay, so those are our points x naught, y naught, right? So let's x naught, y naught. This is our point x1, y, sorry, naught, x naught, y naught, x1, y1. And then this would be x2, y2, and this would be x3, y3. Let me not put the y's on the axis. Piecewise linear interpolation means that between two adjacent points, we draw a line. So we draw a line here. This one will be our function g naught, right, between x naught and x1. We draw a line here. This will be our function g1. And we draw a line here. This will be our function g2. And the whole thing together, we call y equals g of x, okay, this whole curve. For piecewise linear interpolation, the derivative is discontinuous, right? You have a slope, different discontinuity in the slope at each of these points. But it's a continuous function, right, a continuous function. So for piecewise, for a cubic spline interpolation, we will smooth this out. Make the derivatives continuous. Okay, so how do we determine these GI functions? Well, we can write GI is a linear function, so we can write GI of x equals AI, and then for simplicity, we're gonna call this times x minus XI plus BI. So each of these piecewise linear functions have two free constants that we have to determine. How do we determine those constants? Well, we know that gi at the value of xi, which would be g0 at x0, g1 at x1, we know those values. Those are supposed to be equal to yi, right? So that's g has to go through the point on the left. We also know that gi at xi plus 1, which is the point on the right, so g naught at x1, g1 at x2, has to go through the point on the right, so this is supposed to be equal to y sub I plus 1. Okay, so these are our two constraints on g. So each piecewise linear polynomial has two free constants, and two constraints. So that means we can solve for AI and BI. So here we have a BI. We plug in XI here. So we get BI equals YI. And then we can get AI. We plug in X equals XI plus 1. But we know that this is a slope. AI is a slope, so this one will have to be the slope, so it will have to be yi plus 1 minus yi over xi plus 1 minus xi, okay? So we've determined the a's and the b's in terms of the data, xy. Okay, so let me summarize. In this video, I'm introducing the idea of interpolation. So interpolation means that we're given the value of a function at, say, n plus 1 points. Those are the y values. But we don't know the value of the function at other points, not on this list. Other values of x, not on this list. So we need to interpolate. We need to find y at some value of x that is not on the list x0, x1 through xn. The interpolation I'm talking about in this video is piecewise linear interpolation. We set it up by saying that there's a line drawn between each two consecutive points, and that line is a linear function. And then we can determine the coefficients of the linear function in terms of the two points on the ends. In the next two videos, then, I will generalize this to cubic spline interpolation, where instead of taking a linear function for gi, we'll take a cubic polynomial for gi. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.